Synthetic soundscapes.
This is DJ Works. Each week, I will be presenting Synthetic Soundscapes, taking you on a journey through all genres of electronic music. The show will feature music from the archives, listener requests, interviews with producers and DJs, exclusive DJ mixes and new tracks. Join me Sunday nights from 8 to 10 p.m. on Secular Sounds.
Synthetic soundscapes.
This track's Take Me Into the Beautiful from Cloverton, and this is for Angela Brady up in Scotland. Good luck today, Angela.
Take me into the beautiful, won't you take me back again? With the love unexplainable, come and fill up in this dry land. Let it open eyes to see how a world we've never seen. Let it open our hearts up to feel you inside of us, you're inside of me. Take me to the beautiful, where the rivers flow, where the love that never ends. Oh, I wanna go to the beautiful. La 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 la. Take me to the beautiful, where the faces glow, where the light that never dim. Oh, I wanna go to the beautiful. Come on and take me again. Take me into the mystery, gently lift me with your grace. Make the chaos a chorus, with yourself come fill this place. Cover me with your mercy, come and cover me with love. Cover me so that all might see that it's you, not me, it is you that I'm singing of. Take me to the beautiful, where the rivers flow, where the love that never ends. Oh, I want to go to the beautiful.
So that was Take Me Into the Beautiful there from Cloverton, and that was for Angela Brady up in Scotland, who's starting her first Sunday school today. So good luck with that, and good luck with all the kids there. Hope they're listening in. Next up is a message from Lou Webber, and yeah, it's good to have Lou Webber back on the show after a long break in August. So let's give this a listen.
I'd had another one of those conversations that seem all too familiar. They usually start with the words, "I used to be really into all that God stuff and go to church, but..." And what follows is a story of breakdowns in communication, misunderstandings and hurt. The result is that I am hearing the story of how one person has decided God's really not all that great and maybe doesn't really exist in the way they thought God did. Maybe that's a story you can identify with. And I've wondered, why is it that I seem to be hearing similar stories so often? That because of problems with this church or that Christian fellowship, that people decide the God stuff, you know, it's really not for them. And it's much too easy to fall into the trap of apportioning blame to one particular party. But it was a trip to the opticians this week that shone a light into the whole thing for me. You see, I have a cataract developing quite nicely in my left eye, so things that used to seem really clear and defined for me are now not quite so clear to see. The edges get a bit fuzzy. But I found that even though I only just see a little bit clearly, I can usually, 9 times out of 10, just about work out what the thing is or what it says by guesswork. I fill in the blurry bits for myself and hope I get it right. I wonder whether we all have a tendency to do the very same thing with how we see and understand God. We see just a little of the great big picture of all that God is. The rest is filled out and decided in the blurriness of what we think, what we imagine, or what we might hope God to be. The trouble is, our pictures are never really true representations because our imaginations, our understanding, they're incredibly stunted. They're far too small, they're too restrictive and too us-centred. We draw pictures of God in the way we think God should be rather than the way God actually is. And the result? Well, it's people whose vision of God is far too small. No one particular brand of church could ever contain and hold the vastness of the reality of God and God's love and God's inclusivity and God's unmerited favour. So if you've been put off God because of church, please do know that God is not the church. He's far greater. And if you're a member of the church, please remember that the God you represent is far greater than the church you attend.
Thanks, Lou. It's great to have you back. And the track there that's backing Lou up there is You Are My Vision from the Wren Collective Experiment. And here it is. And this is for Sharon Forbes, who I know loves the Wren Collective Experiment, who sound a bit Mumford and Sonsy.
Treasure, you are. I can't.
Well, I hope you enjoyed that. I know some of you did, and I know some of you didn't, but I enjoyed it. I thought it was great, but there you go. Next track up is Here Is Our King from David Crowder Band.
From wherever spring arrives to heal the ground. From wherever searching comes, the look at itself.